Hi there, this is Anvish from PiXimperfect, and today I'm going to share with you how to turn black to white in Photoshop. You see, we have done a lot of videos on changing colors, but we haven't quite done this one because when it comes to turning black to white, things get a little iffy. You see, if you have a picture where you have a dark object, you obviously know that that area doesn't have a lot of details, and part of turning a dark object to brighter one or black to white is making it brighter, right? So when you make it brighter, that object already doesn't have details and you want to discover the details by making it brighter, then pixels begin to break up a little. So we need to find different ways to kind of hide that pixel breaking. That's what this tutorial is all about. So without any further ado, let's get started. Back in the magical world of Photoshop, and if you want to go ahead and download this photo and follow along, check the links in the description. Now, the very first thing to keep in mind when turning an extreme to an extreme, which is black, white, the opposite extremes, is having a precise selection. Now, speaking of precision, this video is sponsored by WACOM tablets. And you know, I've been using one for about 2 to 3, 4 years. I don't know how long, but they are super convenient. WACOM makes the most reliable, durable tablets in the industry. In fact, I have dropped it, crashed it, stepped on it, I don't know how many times. And even I dropped this pen once and stepped on it and even broke it, and it still works. See? The front part of it is broken. Now, the reason why it's important is, of course, you move the mouse as if you are moving a pencil on a piece of paper. So you get that precision of holding a pen or a pencil. And secondly, you get something like pressure sensitivity. With a mouse, you just have on or off. However, with a tablet, you have different levels of pressure sensitivity. And depending upon the pressure, you can change a lot of properties. And also, there's one more thing why I use a WACOM tablet, and that is for convenience. So let's say I've zoomed out and I'm doing something, or if I'm zoomed in. So to fit the canvas to the screen, the shortcut is Control-0. Now, these keys are so far away, so I have to often use two hands. So instead of doing that, you can assign that to one of the express keys right over here. So you press just one key on the WACOM tablet, and it's done. You can assign these keys to whatever you wish. The one that I recommend is the Intuos Pro line, and depending upon your monitor size, you can choose small, medium, or large. To know the exact model that I use, please check the link in the description. Now let's get back to the video. So step one is making a selection of the target area. In this case, I want to turn his shirt, and also in the beginning, let's turn his tie into white as well. We can change the color of the tie later, but let's turn everything white for now. And for the extreme conversions, as we learned, we need to be precise with the selection. And what better tool to create precise selection than the pen tool, right? So let's go ahead and select the pen tool right over here, the shortcut to which is P. Do not forget that. So let's choose the pen tool and zoom in. You can start from any point you wish. So I'm going to start from right here, and you can just click once to create a point. Click and drag to create a curve. Make sure you are very, very precise with this, because even if you move a little too much on either sides, you're going to create some lines which you do not want. All right. Make sure you stay very precise. If you want to create a corner, you can just click and drag to create a curve, and then hold the Alt key or the Option key, click, to just erase the upcoming handle. That way you have a corner right over there. So let me show you one more time. So let's say we are continuing here. And right here, we need a corner. So first, I'll create that curve right over here. And then when I have to turn a corner right here, let's hold the Alt key or the Option key, click on that to break the upcoming handle. And from there, continue. If you want to learn how to use the pen tool, I would highly recommend watching this complete guide. I can guarantee you that after watching this video, you will be a master of the pen tool. Now, to save time, I have already made the path. So let's go to the paths tab. As you can see, I have created one for the shirt and for the tie as well. Always remember, whenever you're creating a path, name it or create a new path from right here and then start creating a path. That way you never lose your paths. For example, I were to create a path right here. Let's delete this one, right? I'm just starting Photoshop with this image and I'm creating a path like this. Okay. I finished the path. Do not forget to go to the Paths tab and rename it. That way you will never lose it. This is just a random circle. Whatever it is, just name it. That way it is stored safely. All right, let's delete this one. We don't need it. So the first thing we need to do is to activate the selection for the path. So we're going to go to the Paths tab, choose the shirt, and then press Control and Enter. That makes a selection of it. That's one way. The other way is hold the control or command and then click on the thumbnail. That does the same thing. Also, if you have the parts selected, you can also right click on it and then choose make selection. You can also add feather right here. Zero is fine. Hit OK. Right, three ways to do the same thing. Moving on to step number two, my friend, and that is take away unnecessary colors. If it's looking black, it doesn't necessarily mean that it's black. It may have a lot of other colors, and also when you brighten it up, you will introduce a lot of color noise. We need to get rid of that in advance. So click on the adjustment layer and then choose hue saturation. Just take the saturation all the way to the left. Now, as you can see, the hue saturation layer is created with that selected area as a mask. Now, as you have already guessed, we're going to add a lot of curves adjustments on top of this. So to keep it clean, why not group it? So with this layer selected, press Ctrl or Command G to create a group of that one layer. And we can name this changing black to white. Okay. And then we can move the mask to the group so that we don't have to create multiple masks or clipping masks or have any of that problem right there. Okay, now just inside the group, just make sure you open the group, and inside the group, we're gonna add a curves adjustment layer. We're gonna make it brighter. And that brings us to simple step number three, and that is just brighten it up. So click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose curves. Now first, let's make sure that the brightest bright of the shirt is white. To do that, all you gotta do is to hold the Alt key or the Option key and click on the rightmost slider right here and slowly and gradually take it to the left. Just when you begin to see artifacts, stop. As you can see, I'm not seeing any artifacts at the moment. Let's take it even further. Now we are beginning to see something. So we can stop right here. What do you feel about that? We are getting somewhere. So first step is done. It's already gray. Now let's make it brighter. Now what I was thinking is the tie is getting too bright. So what we can do here is take it a little bit to the left. Okay, and then for the upcoming curves, we can just erase the tie from there. So let's create one more curves adjustment layer. So click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose curves. And this time we don't want the tie in it. So let's go to the parts again, hold the control or command and click on the thumbnail of the tie. Now the tie is selected. Just make sure the mask is selected and then with the tie selected, fill it with black. With the foreground color as black, press Alt backspace or Option delete. Now this takes away the tie from that layer. Also make sure that we don't have any of the corners. So with this layer selected, you can take the brush, black as the foreground color. Just make sure that all of these areas are away. Okay, good. Now let's make it even brighter. So hold the Alt key or the Option key and take the slider from the right to the left. Just when you begin to see artifacts, stop. So at this point, I begin to see some. So we're gonna stop right over here, okay? That looks good. We are getting it brighter and brighter. Now, as you can see, it's not getting white. It's turning silver. You know why? Because black had a lot of gloss in it. We need to get rid of that. For it, again, create one more curves adjustment layer. So click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose curves. And even in this, we do not want the tie. So hold the Alt key or the Option key and click and drag the tie mask to this one. We definitely want to replace the mask. So hit yes. So let's select the properties of the curves adjustment layer and just create a point in the middle and brighten it up. See, we are slowly and gradually turning him into Agent 47, right? Gamers would know what this is. So this looks okay. Also, there's one more thing we need to do. We need to add one more curves. Again, we just love curves, don't we? So let's copy this mask right here as well. And we need to brighten the shadows this time. So open the curves properties. Take it up just like that. Just focus on the shadows this time. So we only want to limit it to the shadows. What does that remind you of? Blend if. So double click on the right hand side of the layer. That opens up the layer styles dialog box. Now all we gotta do is to just take it away from the highlights. So take the slider of the underlying layer from right to left. But that is harsh. So hold the Alt key or the Option key. Click on the slider to break it apart and take these halves all the way apart. And there you go. Isn't that pretty amazing? Now there's one problem with this. If you zoom in, have a look at these areas, the pixels are breaking. And since these areas had no details in them, it is just totally clipped. We will later find a way to hide it, but just know that you will not have details in this area. You just have to accept that fact. Photographers, it is always best that if you want the shirt to be white, just making wear a white t-shirt or a shirt, whatever you like. Also, photo editors, don't get upset, because if you're working with raw photos, you wouldn't have to face this problem. I chose a challenging image just to show you what you would do in case you have no details, and we'll get to that later. Time for step number four, and that is simply, let's give the tie some color. So let's close and collapse this group. So let's make a selection of the tie first. So in the paths tab, you already have that. So hold the control or command and click on the thumbnail to activate that selection, and now create a solid color adjustment layer. You can give the tie whatever color you wish. So click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose solid color. Solid color will be created with that selection as a mask. So I'm going to give it red, some bright red color. You can make it darker later, doesn't matter right now. I want to turn this into Agent 47, so let's choose that color and hit OK. Now the tie is already bright, we want this color to darken it. So let's change the blend mode from normal to multiply. You're getting that vibe, isn't it? So let's make it a little brighter. How do you feel about that? And add a little more saturation to it. If H is selected and we take it to the right, the saturation increases. Hit OK. There's some flaw in the selection right there. We can easily fix that. Not a big deal. So select this mask right there. Take the brush and then just paint with white over that. That's not a big deal. We can easily fix that. That's why I told you, we need to be very, very precise with these selections, especially when you're working with extremes. Okay. There you are. It's looking pretty good. Now, what I would also do is make the tie a little brighter, right? We should do that. So let's create a curves adjustment layer. You can also have both of them in a group just to make things a little simpler. And let's take it up like this. Just focus on the tie for now. The tie looks good. What do you think? Yes, it looks good. Now let's put both of them in a group. So select the first one, hold the control or command, select the second one, control or command G to group it. And we want the group to have the mask. So let's drag the mask and drop it on the group. Now it is simplified. So here is the before and here is the after. Take a look at our hitman. Isn't that amazing? If your image doesn't have any flaw right now, you can stop right here. If you're working with raw images, really good quality raw photos, you wouldn't have any flaws right now. But if it does have flaws, like I do have right now, with the pixels breaking up and the shadows looking crazy, we need to do some damage control right here. And that is the final step, damage control. So click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose curves. And we are trying to create a spotlight effect. You can try a lot of ways. You can add overlays, a lot of things to do damage control to cover things up. And that is the step, the cover up. You can do whatever you want. I'm thinking that maybe we can do a spotlight effect. So we can just take the shadows down just like this. Okay. And only make his face area a little brighter, creating a spotlight effect. So with the mask selected, take the brush with black as the foreground color. We're going to just dab once right here. There you go. It does create a very nice spotlight effect. You can press Ctrl or Command T and make the spotlight a little longer if you wish to. There you go. Yeah, that looks pretty decent. I'm going to move it a little bit to the left. Adjust it accordingly, and there you have it. So here's the before, here's the after. It hides the bottom part of it well. Now there's one more thing we can do. We can use some fantastic overlays and textures to cover it up. And my favorite place for overlays, textures, and any Photoshop asset, as you know, is Envato Elements. They have everything you need. So let's search for, I'm just thinking, maybe let's go for film overlays. Let's see what do they have. And let's scroll down. These are stock videos. These are sound effects, music, photos, video templates, graphic templates, done of that. Now inside of graphics category, we have 789 graphics for just film overlays. And you can just browse through it or just look at the top search results. So I'm liking this one. So let's go ahead and download this directly. And it comes with a license. Yes, you can use it commercially, which is amazing. So I'm going to choose the project title for this and simply download it. The reason why I genuinely recommend Envato Elements over everything else is because it gives you unlimited assets of all kinds on top of that. It's not just stock photos, it's not just stock videos. It's also sound effects, 3D models, Photoshop add-ons like plugins, presets, brushes, every creative asset that you can think of unlimited for just one monthly fee. You have unlimited access. Look everywhere. Either they are not giving as vast a category of creative assets that you need, or they're charging per image or per creative asset, which gets very, very pricey. If you're looking for unlimited high-quality creative assets, look no further than Envato Elements. Everything is included with your membership. To check out the latest offers, do check the link in the description, and I can personally guarantee you that you won't be disappointed with the amount of assets that you get. So this is the overlay set that we just downloaded. Let's open that up. And there are tons of overlays right here that you can use. So I'm going to go with just one at random. Let's go with two. Let's drag it and drop it into Photoshop just like this. Adjust it accordingly. Now all you got to do is to try different blend modes. You can try overlay, or in this case, I would choose screen right here. It covers most of the flaws, but it kind of does it too much. So we need to adjust it just a little bit. So click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose curves. Now we only want to apply the curves to this texture. So click on this button. It creates a clipping mask. That means it limits the curve just to this texture. So we're going to make it a little darker so that it affects it less. So this looks like a good place to be. Now let's collapse that and take a look at the before and after. So this is the before, absolutely black, and this is the after, Agent 47. Now if you wish, you can do some further adjustments to add more contrast, and this is my final result. I hope this video helped you. Let's do a quick little recap. First of all, we need to have a very precise selection, and I would highly recommend Pen Tool for doing it. After you have a precise selection, take away the unnecessary colors. You can do this by hue saturation adjustment layer. After that, you can add a couple curves just to brighten it up, and you will be done. And after that, you can add some different colors to the tie. You can do some damage control. If you see the pixels breaking or the dark areas clipping, you would know what to do. There are tons of things. You can add textures like we did right here. You can add some more contrast. You can add a spotlight effect, or you can even add a gradient map to kind of add some style to it as well. Just know that when it comes to turning one extreme to the other extreme on the opposite side, you're gonna make some pixels sad, but that's the part of the process. I hope this video helped you, and if it did, make sure to give us a like, and also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe, ring the bell so that you, my friend, don't miss any other future tips, tricks, or tutorials. I would like to take this moment to thank all these nice and amazing people for supporting PiXimperfect on Patreon and helping keep PiXimperfect free for everybody forever. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating.